Good afternoon and welcome to First Methodist Forney. I am Reverend Gary Turner. I am the interim senior pastor here at First Methodist Forney for about four more days, technically, but this is my last service with this congregation. I've been the interim pastor here since January of this year. And during this time, this congregation has been going through the study of experiencing God, knowing and doing the will of God. I preached a seven-week sermon series on it, and we have been having classes on Sunday evening, and it has so impacted our understanding of how God wants to touch his people that the choir has been preparing this musical for about 4 months now in order to present to you in music what we have been studying and hearing throughout my ministry here. And so I'm grateful for all of your presence here today, grateful for our instrumentalists, the choir, the children, but most of all, grateful to God that he has brought us to this place to experience his love today, and that is my deepest prayer. We will be receiving an offering midway through the presentation, and that offering will go to bless and benefit the Forney Food Pantry. And so I'll give you a heads up there. If you're a guest and you would like to know more about this congregation, there's a guest card in the pew rack in front of you there. You can fill that out and drop it in the offering plate whenever it is passed, and someone will be happy to follow up with you and tell you about this congregation. Now let's go to God in prayer. Gracious, loving God, we are amazed that the Creator of the universe would call us into relationship with you. The Maker of all things would find a single soul worthy of love. So, Lord, during this time, as the choir sings and the instrumentalists play, let us be touched by that love, that we may know that we are your children through Jesus Christ our Lord, in whose name we pray. Amen.
Moses, take off your shoes, for the ground on which we stand is holy ground.
Take off your shoes, this is holy ground.
bring aboard two of every living creature, for I am going to flood the earth.
I am speechless. What kind of love would this be that would trade heaven's throne for a cross? And indeed you still celebrate over finding just one who was all. And to know you rejoice over us, the God of this whole universe, in the story too great for words. Thank you.
God, push aside every competing distraction. Let us look directly into the loving face of our Savior. And once our eyes open, we can see that we have been blessed with every spiritual blessing. Thank you for choosing us before the creation of the world to be adopted as your sons and daughters through Jesus. This is your pleasure and this is your will to know us and love us intimately as a father loves his child.
When I fall
So the underlying principle of the study experiencing God is that God is already at work around us. And as those who consider ourselves his followers, we are to do what Jesus did, and that is Jesus looked to see where the Father was working and joined him there. And one of the places that we see Jesus working in our community here in Forney is through the Forney Food Pantry. And so in order to join Jesus in his work at the Forney Food Pantry, we're going to receive an offering this afternoon, kind of an interlude to our musical presentation. And I would ask that if you are so moved to join Jesus in that work, that you would make a contribution. And so if the ushers would come forward and bring the offering plates. Got to recruit the usher. But we can always take an offering. Never fail. Don't worry. We will not fail to do that. We can do this. So as they come, let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for the good work that you are doing in our midst. And now, O God, receive the offerings that we make as an expression of our desire to join you in what you're doing through Jesus our Savior. Amen. How awesome to know that the God of the universe wants to have a father-child relationship with us. He's inviting us to join him in the work of reconciling the world to himself. When God came to Moses or Abraham or the disciples, he didn't ask, "What would you like to do for me?" He already had a plan. And they each had to make some major adjustments before he could work that plan out in their lives. God still operates that way. He's not asking us, "What would you like to do for me?" He's already got a plan. And if we let him, he is more than able to carry out his plans in us and through us.
Oh,
Lord God, you know the desire of our hearts is to follow you where you lead us. The longing in each of us is to know you, to hear your voice, to encounter you in a meaningful way. Thank you, Lord, that you are here today. Amen. You know, the deep longing that we feel to encounter God is actually the beginning of the encounter itself, for only God can place that longing in our hearts. We don't have to strain our ears to hear him. He's always speaking to us. For instance, have you ever been reading the Bible when suddenly you're gripped with a fresh new understanding? That was God speaking. When this happens, write it down, meditate on it, immerse yourself in it. Ask God to show you what adjustments you need to make to bring that into your life. Then make those adjustments and watch to see how God uses it. God also speaks to us through his body, the church. The members of Christ's body guide his church in the same way that the members of the human body guide the body. For example, suppose you were walking down a train track when suddenly your ears informed you that a train whistle was blowing somewhere very near. Then your feet warned you of the rumbling motion of an approaching train. Wouldn't you get off those tracks as soon as possible? Well, we in the church can learn to trust each other in exactly the same way. The most important way we hear from God is when we enter his presence to pray. There's no substitute for prayer. There's no way to be in God's presence and remain unchanged. Prayer is a two-way communication with God in which listening is more important than talking. As we pray, the Holy Spirit leads us into all truth. But truth is not just a concept. Truth is a person. To pray is to know Jesus Christ, who is truth.
Thank you.
God can also speak to us through our circumstances, the good things and the bad. But we need to be careful not to judge him from the middle of bad things. This was a lesson that Henry Blackaby experienced firsthand when his child was diagnosed with cancer at age 16. We suffered as we watched the sickness that goes along with chemotherapy and radiation, Blackaby said. Some people face such an experience by blaming God and questioning, why doesn't he love me anymore? The cancer treatments could have been very devastating for us, but did God still love us? Yes, he did. Had his love changed? No, it had not. When you face circumstances like this, you can question and ask God to show you what is going on. We did that. We had to ask God what we should do. We asked all those questions, but I never said, Lord, I guess you don't love me. At times, I went before the Heavenly Father, and I saw behind my child the cross of Jesus Christ. And I said, Father, don't ever let me look at my circumstances and question your love. Your love for me was settled on the cross. That has never changed, and it never will.
Thank you.
Thine own way, Lord, have thine own way.
Here in God's presence this afternoon, He's opened our eyes to who He is and how much He loves us. Let's stop right now and open ourselves to Him. Oh Lord, You've captured our hearts with Your love. You've opened our eyes to the reality of who You are. We are in awe of Your mercy. That You would send Your own Son to die for us. That You would welcome us into Your presence as Your sons and daughters. That You hear us when we pray and lift us when we fall. And call us into a relationship with You. Oh God, we see so clearly that there is no life apart from You. We choose this day to love You and follow You. There will be no turning back. Our lives are in Your hands.
Thank you.
Thank you, Melissa, for blessing me with kind of a final offering on behalf of the choir and this congregation. I cannot tell you, members of this church, how truly blessed we have been to be with you for 6 months and just to absolutely see the mighty way that God has moved in 6 months. There's a quote from Blackaby that says, God can do more in 6 months with a life that is totally devoted to him than he can do in 60 years on our own. So this church is experiencing that, and I know that you will continue to experience God under the direction of Pastor Nick McRae, who will be here next Sunday. If you are not a member of this congregation, but you would like to have more information, please contact the church and find out more. If you have never accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior, please catch me actually, we're going to go over and have ice cream. So you can talk to me over there over ice cream, and that will really bless us. But anyway, I hope that you will accept Christ as your Lord and Savior, because there is no greater life in all of the world than that. Now let's stand and receive this benediction. Go out in peace and in the knowledge and love of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and join God in where he is working in your life, in your area, in your particular way, through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. Ice cream is in the Family Life Center in the building just to our west. Please join us for ice cream.